Hey everybody, this is Eddie the Adventurer, and this is Stockfish. This is codfish, which has been dried out and has retained less than 1% water content. This is one of the hardest food that's known in the world. It is almost impenetrable, and it's also been a staple food in Scandinavia during the Viking Age. In this video, I'm going to be visiting a facility where they will be processing these. It's on a little island called Vare, and this is where they produce the most stockfish in all of Norway, as well as exporting the most to the whole world. Vare has a city hall, one supermarket, one church, one pub, one convenience store, one gasoline stand, and one police officer who goes back and forth every week between Vare and Rus, the neighboring island.
Okay, Vare is a very, very nice place to live, mostly because of the kindness of the people who live here. The population here is only 730 people, plus minus. A place like this, almost everybody knows each other. Four or five families are the basic for the whole population. Then you have some people coming from other places like me, myself. And the speed in the daily life is not as stressful as in the big cities. And of course the nature is fantastic. The weather changes a lot. Vare is a weather island. Beautiful summer day to full winter storms. And of course, one more thing about Vare is the quality of the fish products. They are the best of the world, this fish, especially the cod in winter time. And you have the halibut in the summertime. And of course, you have access to whale meat, dry cod fish. They export a lot to Italy, Portugal. Mostly everything here has something to do with fish. The whole community is based on fishing. I think that covers it.
My name is Jim, I'm 66 years old, I'm a fisherman, I've been all my life, and I will be it until I die. The company's name is Tinskjær, and it's me and my brother and my younger son. I lived on this island, Weather Island, all my life, and well, it's a good place to live on. We live from catching fish, it's a good, very good food.
Perfectly there. Come and mind the auto. Oh, better or hippo. But Utsura was keen on the fresk. If we hang 100 kilo up, we get 23 kilo dry. So it's a concentrate of have this beautiful taste that make this product so very special. Revolution has been going on for 1,000 years. And before we got a refrigerator, freezer, it was the only way to preserve it because there's a lot of fish here in the wintertime. Take it up from the sea, cut the head out of the stomach, hang it up 3 months, and let it dry. And now we can stand in this position for 10 years and you can eat it still.
You don't add salt or anything to it?
No, nothing. Just a pure natural product. My job here is to find out what kind of quality.
How do you see the difference?
You see the skin, if it's bloody inside, and you take a look at the hair up in the neck, and if it's warm in the temperature, it can be brown inside there.
They go out fishing starting in January, and from February to April, that's when they hang up the fish to dry. Winter here on Vare is mild compared to the rest of Norway due to the Gulf Stream coming from the west side. And on top of that, the wind is very strong, and so it makes this island a very ideal spot for drying fish. And now they are separating them based on the size and quality. Then they will ship it to the mainland and the surrounding European countries, with Italy being the biggest importer.
Hvor er største fisk?
skryter på deg igjen.
2,7.
Det er tøngste, men lengste.
Ja. De her er den store, de har veldig lett for å bli dårlig for først lang tid for de tørska.
Ja.
Ja, og så surer de.
So how much would that cost?
Well, 500 kroner.
The weather's been too hot. So this is about 130-140 pounds, this kilo, and this 300. Here's the instruments.
Yeah.
Som mange kan se når de ligger på havet og så er gruk og sånn. På arbeid så er det ingen oppe, det er nede alle. Nede på arbeidsstreket, så manøvrerer de båten der. Så det blir litt sånn intenst. Så da skipper skal han først passe på å være fisker nede på dekk, samtidig som han skal holde orden på hva som skjer oppe her. Det begynner å stresse han seg først. De som flyger da, de er interessert i fly.
Ja.
Ikke hver mann skal flyge.
Nei da, det er
interessant. Det er interesse
som gjør det. Ja, det er det.
I før i tiden var det de seilet og rådde, så var det kanskje plutselig kommet uvær. De har jo ikke noe værmelding. Så lå de på havet, og så rett og slett båtene de ble nedbrøtt med deres, tippet rundt under seilen til land. Så det var omkommet som regel de fleste. 6-7-8 mann på hver båt, og det var mange, mange ulykker. Ja. Likens med været også, akkurat det samme, og jeg er ikke lovfor. Det var harde tider.
Men så kom værmeldingen.
Ja, og båtene ble jo bedre, typ kontoret og alt det her, så det var noe. Det har jannet seg ut, så nå er det ikke så ofte at det skjer. Det kan jo være kanskje av og til at noen dett på havet, noe sånne ulykker, at det blir ombord i båten, at det er hva som skjer.
Sonogram to detect the fish?
Ja. Echosonder. Echosonder, radar. We have got the map. It's instruments for detecting the fish and navigation.
What is the phone for? For calling your wife? Or?
Ja da, den den får vi under radiokontrollen ombord, så tester de hvert det utstyret her.
And
talk to my wife too. or the small wives.
I was just
Så vi en rad her, og så her den.
On one trip, how long do you go out?
Three days. But in the winter, a lot of fish every day, so we go to the harbor every day. Out late in the evening and back in the middle of the day.
Right next door is Lofoten Viking. They deal with the fish heads. They load them up into these big yellow crates and then ship it off to Nigeria, where the dried fish heads are in high demand. The bones and the guts, you guys don't process that? Or just throw it away?
They're up in these tanks.
Okay.
And all the guts go into the tank with some pipelines. They put something to conserve it so it can stay there. Take it over to Bodø, where it's a big factory that produces fish meal for salmon food. And the liver, they send it to Ballstad, where they produce tran. Tran is a liver oil.
Omega-3.
Yeah, okay. And the raw is going to be a cod-raw caviar.
So there's nothing in the fish that you throw away, you use everything?
No, nothing. Everything is used.
So the real question is, how do you eat this? Because even with your tough biceps and inbred canine teeth, it's seemingly impossible. So back then, the Vikings always had hammers with them and they would pound it up until it was tender and then they would eat the smaller bits and pieces that comes off of it. Hey! I hope you enjoyed the video. If you would like to see more videos of Vare and Norway, please check out the videos on my left and right side. The middle button is where you can subscribe and see my upcoming videos. That's also fun to click. I'll see you all next time. Peace.